So, let us have some information regarding energy audit instruments. Energy audit means the verification, monitoring, and analysis of use of energy and submission of technical report and recommendation for the reduction in energy consumption. That means if I say I need to audit an industry, I'm going to verify, monitor, and analyze. What we have to analyze? Obviously, whatever product, whatever processes, whatever instruments available, that need to analyze. That means energy audit is a particular audit just like a financial audit. The auditor may be you. Go there inside the factory, into the industry, verify whatever the processes are there, see the instruments which are available. For example, if boiler is available, so boiler is, that means it generates steam. So steam means we need to check the temperature and pressure of the output steam. So whatever different processes, different instruments available, which consumes energy, that we have to monitor under this audit. Once we monitor that, we have to find something, a particular thing which shows us there is a wastage of energy. So for example, in some of the systems, there is some air conditioning system is there. In air conditioning system, if the proper insulation is not provided, okay, so there is a loss of energy because of leakages through walls. So we have to monitor that, such type of things. And that particular technical report we have to prepare. And the technical report in which we must write, yes, these are the lacunas, these are the limitations, these are the opportunities for the energy saving. And we have to say something about the action plan. Yes, here the insulation is required. Here the replacement of this instrument is required. In some of the cases, the processes also get modified. So that are the action plans we have to suggest. Okay. In any industry, what are the basic measurement parameters generally in any industry? So industry means it has some electrical instruments. Electrical instruments are having basic parameters like voltage, current, resistance, power, power factor, active power, apparent power, reactive power, energy consumption, frequency, harmony, light. So all these parameters which are under the electrical parameter. In some cases, we need to have dimensional parameters. We have to measure, we have to monitor length, area, volume. The thermodynamic parameter. In some of the cases, we must measure heat flow, temperature measurement, pressure measurement, volume measurement, viscosity, humidity. In mechanical parameter, vibration, noise, RPM, lubrication, all these need to measure. In case of pollution parameter, dust, flue gases, combustion, total dissolved solid, and pH factor. So these are the parameters we need to measure. For this particular, all the basic parameters, we need some instruments. Without instruments, you cannot measure that. There may be chances that wherever we go for the audit, wherever a person go for the audit, that industry may have these instruments, but not necessary. One more thing, you cannot stop the industry for measurement, because if you stop some industry for this audit, then there is a loss of production and company never allow you. That means you must have the instruments which are, if it is non-contact type, then preferred. So that means all the non-contact type measuring instruments which are required. So you did not touch the instruments which are already running. Then only industry can allow you. Otherwise, nobody is going to allow you inside the industry for audit. So is such type of instruments are available? The answer is yes. So in this particular lecture, we are going to see what are the different measuring instruments. Let us start with the electrical measure. Electrical measurement, that means electrical voltage, current, harmonics, power, power factor, active power, apparent power, reactive power, energy consumption, and frequency. Now you might have heard about voltage, current, and resistance in some previous study or in some previous years, but you might have don't know about the active power, apparent power, or reactive power. As we know, there is a power factor. So what is that power factor? Power factor is generally denoted by cos of pi. So that power factor shows whether the power is inductive power or capacitive power. So as far as electrical power is concerned, the power factor should be exactly one. If you don't have one power factor, then there is an active power, there is apparent power, there is a reactive power, and you need to separately measure this. So what is the apparent power? It is a demand power. What is the active power which is supplied, and what is the reactive power which is need to measure whatever additional power required in this all instrument. So energy consumption is also important. How much amount of kilowatt of power is required in hour? Okay, so that is kWh. Frequency. We know that in our India, we are having a particular 50 hertz frequency instruments. So these instruments and these different parameters that can be measured by using the figure shown here. Multimeter and harmonics are the measuring instrument for the voltage, current, and resistance. And power analyzer are the instruments, which are all these instruments almost non-contact type. These are going to measure all electrical parameters. These parameters you can note down for any of the instruments. For example, you are going to monitor a pump which is fitted for the chemical supply. That pump might be a simple induction motor. That induction motor is having again voltage, three phase voltage, current capacity, and all these things. So how much amount of current is supplied, how much power that is going to output power on the shaft, how much is required and how much is utilized, all these things are going to monitor. Okay, so and that can be a length area measurement. So linear measurement. In the linear measurement, nowadays we need not go with tape and everything. There's a laser instrument is available, non-contact type. So wherever sometimes you may need to measure the distance from one instrument to another instrument to calculate some losses and something like that. For example, in our industry there is assembly line and there is a compressor. the compressor is going to supply air so that the assembly line instrument can run pneumatically. So in that case, you think that there is a very large distance between this compressor line and the assembly line. So obviously the compressed air is passed through the pipe. And we think, you may think that this particular pipe is very, very large in length. Then you can measure the length by using such type of linear. Now temperature measurement. You can see here, there is a contact type, there is a non-contact type, there is a low, high, there is a probe type, infrared type, and thermal imager type. So in front of you, there are three figures. The first figure is contact type, low temperature probe. The first figure is contact, low temperature probe. So you can directly put that probe on the surface of the instrument and you will get the temperature. So this can be, this instrument is used where the temperature is not more than 200 degrees centigrade. It can be used up to 250, so not more than that. Because it is very dangerous to keep a human being or probe which is going to touch to the temperature more than 300. So that's why one should not take use of this contact type of instrument if the temperature is very high. So the next instrument is infrared type. Infrared instrument is a non-contact type. The non-contact type instrument, temperature measurement instrument, you might have seen everywhere nowadays because of this corona temperature measurement instrument. So it is an infrared instrument, which is non-contact type instrument. In industry also, this non-contact type temperature measurement, infrared temperature measurement is used if the temperature is high or you cannot directly contact that instrument. The next instrument is thermal imager. So thermal imager is one more instrument that directly specify the variation of temperature on the instrument. In some of the cases, we need to monitor the instrument surface. For example, you may have pump puri tarah se garam ho chuka hai kya, ya fir some part of the pump becomes hot. That you can sense by using thermal imager. You see, evaporator ka temperature dekhna hai. Evaporator mein uniformly temperature distribution ho raha hai kya? That you can take directly by using this thermal imager. Thermal imager mein you can have a shades of different temperatures. Where the high temperature is there, it shows very, very hot with red color. So such type of different shades that you can see by using this thermal imager, and you can sense the variation in the temperature surface to surface. Now, if I want to measure the flow, so in the flow also, there are some contact type and non-contact type flow measurement. So you can see there is a heated tube, there is an ultrasonic type of non-contact type flow measurement, there is a anemometer. Anemometer is used for the air flow. So air or flue gases flow, or where there is a gas which is to be measured. So in this case, in this flow measurement, as we know in industry, nobody is going to allow you to open any pipe. So if I open some chemical pipe, or if I open some water pipeline also to measure the flow, then the production directly affects. So nobody is going to allow you to directly put something inside the running system. So that's why you need to have a ultrasonic type of flow measurement which can directly put on that pipeline. So the ultrasonic type of system or anemometer, which is directly used to measure the flow of air, is used for the monitoring this type of system. For example, we have to measure how much amount of cold air is flowing through the air conditioning system. So that you can use anemometer so that you can measure the flow of that cold air. So again, if you think about the pressure measurement, also nowadays manometers and gauges are there which directly sense the pressure. So there is a digital manometer, there is a digital gauges which are available which shows the pressure. Main important thing in industry is there is a measurement of fuel gases which comes out from the combustion chamber. Wherever there is a fuel may be petrol, it may be diesel, it may be furnace oil, it may be LPG or any other gases which are used. So wherever there is a burning, obviously because of burning there is a carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, oxygen, CO2 and all the different gases which comes out. So we have to analyze this. So for that analysis, because here energy audit also checks is there any pollution or not. To monitor, to analyze this particular gases also includes the monitoring of gases which again increase or decrease the pollution, because the auditor should not suggest to pollute environment. So we must think about the how much quantity of combustion and what type of gases which are coming out from the combustion. So for that pyrite is the very common type of instrument which is used to measure this, and there is a flue gas analyzer also. So that is also one of the instrument which is used there. Now in addition to that, there is a TDS, pH and humidity, total dissolved solids, total dissolved solid in any water, or total dissolved solid in any gases, or what is the pH value, whether the fluid which is coming out is the acidic or basic type, or how much amount of humidity available, and obviously dry point and dew point temperature, all these things that can be measured by using hygrometer and TDS and pH tester. These are the two instruments that is shown here that can measure the pH, TDS and humidity inside the water or fluid. Now in addition to that, many times in industry we need to measure the speed or the velocity. So for that we need to have a tachometer, which is contact type of instrument which can directly we can put to the running system so that we can measure that. Or we can have a stroboscope. Stroboscope is the non-contact type instrument which is used to measure the speed or RPM. In addition to that, in many industries, the light and lux or lumen of light is important. How much is the intensity of light? How much is the reference index? Whether the whatever light inside the industry which is sufficient for the particular human being or the process or the production process or not, that you must check. So suppose we are having CNC precision making machine. So in the CNC precision making machine, it is very necessary that the luminance of light or the lux of light in the area of that particular CNC machine chamber should be sufficient so that there should not be any fatigue to the worker or the operator. So that is important. That is important, and we can check. We can check the lumen or lux or intensity of light by using such type of lux meter. So lux meter is one more instrument which is used to measure the. There are some leakages which are observed during the audit. Audit again has to check the leakages. There is a leakages inside the steam pipeline. There is a leakages in air pipeline. There is leakage in water or other fluid pipelines. So we can check. We can check the leak. So there is a leak detector, contact tape and non-contact tape leak detector is in front of you. There is a separate instrument which is called as a steam tap tester, which is used to check the steam which is coming out from the steam trap. How much are the amount of steam is leak through the steam trap? That we can check by using the steam trap. So all these instruments are used to check the leakages. There is a vibration and noise. These problems are again very common in the industry. If that particular machine becomes old, or it is overloaded, or it is having a very bad foundation, then obviously it creates some vibration and noise. So indirectly, the efficiency of that instrument, which will go down because of vibration and noise. And it also affects on the worker and the employee. So that's why vibration and noise also the auditor should check. So for that we need a vibration analyzer and noise test. So these are the few instruments. If we have these instruments, we can go to any industry for the audit. Now, if you just see, all these instruments are almost non-contact type, or these instruments, whatever we have shown here, these instruments is not going to disturb any production line, or it is not going to disturb any instrument. By using this instrument, we can check all the parameters without or very little touch, minor touch to the instrument. So with this, we'll say that before audit, we must have these measuring instruments with us.